Hey, what up, guys? I hope you're doing good. I just wanted to do a quick little video because I find I negligate you a little bit, guys. So perhaps I have to put a little discipline once every 2 weeks, I should think so, and maybe some songs. But I got tired a little bit to play like the songs note for note with the music sheet. It's very helpful, but you end up forgetting a lot. And if we incorporate the song best, you have to like to feel it. So it's not just playing the notes, and it's understanding like, oh, okay, we're switching chord now. Then I get carried away, just saying, telling you. As an artist, you have ups and downs, and I was pretty high when I did my first parts of video. I hope to find some inspiration to come back strong again one day. But I wanted to add a little something different and stop talking, maybe more about it. But this one I wanted to take more different, like just talking about stuff and little observation I do towards like studying Hendrix, and maybe just explain it to you guys, gonna like clarify things from myself. That's what happened when you teach. So you seem like a generous person, but we kind of both benefit. So I'm gonna like was thinking quick to just go a little deeper in technical stuff, how Hendrix plays. And I don't even know if it's such a good thing to follow all this. I do them like for me because I'm in that kind of quest of finding the Hendrix feeling, how he attacked the strings. So there's a technicality, like it comes from the mind, but your body has to fingers put in the correct position. And so I just do that like instinctively, but just looking at him and try to imitate the sound. So I maybe never gonna have the confirmation that's a proper technique, but even then you can like find your own sound and do little thing different. It's all fine that in a And as I was saying, it's a danger because we don't want to put necessarily all guitarists playing like Hendrix because he has a very unique kind of way he attacks the strings, especially the right hand. Well, it's left hand for him, the picking hand, and how he plays with the thumb, and it has powerful like effects, which give the Hendrix characteristics, unique sound, but same time you're gonna get kind of limited of sounding like this after. So if you like to me, it can become some kind of frustration because nowadays of super good guitarists and play quite fast scale stuff, and I feel like that's I cannot like do that super clean like who knows but again I don't care. I'm working more on the have a sharper clean sound striking out like during Hendrix solo. You hear like the how he does that. So it's how he pushes the string. So I wanted to talk about a little bit about that, but I can see also it's totally fine to not study at all this and stay like with your usual technique and still adjust like learning the songs and through it. Even if it's not the right tone of Hendrix tone, it's totally fine. And maybe in some cases it could be really better because you're gonna play other stuff which is gonna sound like most of the other guitarist. So once I'm talking about this, jump in. It's I wanted to talk about the pick today. So there's a lot of variation how you can hold it. So most of them guitarists could be like inside if, but he, and it's a lot in the wrist too, but like as I understand Hendrix, like it's different. And you, I just wanted to play because I saw him, I look at his fingers. I have been such a fan, so and I wanted to try to find that sound. Maybe I don't know why, but to me it was important. So like yeah, it's more like I think like this, and of course he can rest this finger on the second a little bit, so it gives like and I look, there's the angle, oh you can hold the pick and here are closer. Of course if you're too close most of your flesh gonna hit the strings, but all those subtle details like gonna make a good guitarist like Hendrix, because he doesn't always have like the same. That's every note's gonna sound like this. Of course with the flesh you can have the harmonic stuff. It's not easy to do, but you have to use the pick and the flesh of your thumb. And it's okay if you, like I said, you can play like you have guys like this, like most of the guitar. Like. But once you learn one technique, your hand's gonna end up placing like this. So if you like this and it's totally good to play like this. So anyway. I can just, it's good to be conscious. I was just strumming chords and I find you can sound like light or more. So I was just strumming on that, not strumming on that or being conscious. Like this is like I'm less down, I'm just a little bit more like this, and so I just, so like the Hendrix strum is short, it's, I mean it's small movement, but the short and the angle of the wrist gives a, and there's a lot of you can, it's easy to switch on the treble and bass, and this is like down up down up down up, just like you switch the bass is a, so just that you practice a lot of groove, and the thing is to keep up down and you can play the ML. Of course, it's good to have like the action of 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And of course, it gets a lot more texture if you separate the chord. Then there's no right or wrong, so that's good. So anyway, but that's what is cool with the Hendrix, this style. And of course, like the wrist is pretty high. A lot of guitars play the wrist almost touch, And it gives a lot of advantages, I guess, with that angle, but Hendrix is that kind of butt. That's why also I find it give a powerful sound, because it's like a little bit of, you can, even if you're not like resting on the other string, but you can sometimes. And I find like when I was doing this lick, bending and then this you just switch the fingers on the string, bending. But I find if you don't like rest, you're gonna hear the two. It's almost impossible to switch because you still hold the other string, but if you mute. So, and it becomes like once you practice your groove and just the paint attention, hammering pull-ups and bending, it becomes fun to play around with it. And of course, a little here and there you can add a note. This third one. Anyway, I wanted to stay with the pick. So what else could I say? So I find out, I guess, most of the time. Because there's the angle, the pick like this, the string, and like this Hendrix is most of the time is like this. So it's a really strange at first when you try this, because if you played your whole life like this, it's a total new universe. My feeling like this is, you may sometimes play like this, I'm not sure. Because like the way you strum a chord like this, or it's a total different sound, and you may want to reach that effect. So I don't have all the answers yet. But when you play like short string, two or three string, it gives a cool sound, and Hendrix rarely play like it because it's like too full. You give every all the so it's more like a foxy lady. All right, and so there's a lot of down strokes with small movements. Could be like a little bit with the arm and other wrist, but there's a lot of down stroke with Hendrix. It's a light touch, I find. Because it simplified to improvise like a couple little riff with the rhythmic, you have, this is your timing. Of course it's cool when once in a while you can still like do the down and up, but not all the time. And with the this is a really cool one. It's like instead of doing like do pompe. So it's two on the bass and one on and, but you can always switch, but one, two, one, two, one, two. And there's not a lot of but sometimes you can see Hendrix playing with the A finger. Well, it's a rare occasion. So I just wanted to say, so it's important to work on, this is like what's gonna give you groove. And if you get to work on that, no matter what is the note, and then you do chords progression and some. Sometimes it's cool to play chords, not okay. I'm doing like a, or just the tom and those are just a minor. Or sometimes it's just like a, just two string. All right, and one thing about what I could say at the end, it's you can take like precisely one note and it gives a clean riff. Anything, but you can like a little bit. Even if it's one note, you kind of. So it's a bit sloppy, but you kind of mute. So anyway, just saying, just playing. So I guess that's it for now. Maybe it's enough. And I'll try to pick a song. Perhaps I was thinking do it more by heart, and when you do it by heart, you kind of. It's okay if you improvise your little variation of not the exact melody, not the exact riff, because that's why I'm trying to reach you. Like Hendrix doesn't play like exactly the same thing twice, so you have to put that in your mindset and put it into practice. And it's a not so easy thing to do, and it's good to have a lot of licks, you know, which. You know that the note's gonna work. All you can do is perhaps change a little. The same lick, but just change like the. And as long as you're like on time with the chord, so. I was just like trying to improvise a little. So when you do that, you can try to be creative with your, which all you do a chord. So it's not like okay, I do an F, like and then it's G, which is it's good if you be at least you're on the right chord at the right time. And if you for singers. It's enough, and you can just mute. And like that kind of songs is made like this at first, from like Bob Dylan. But Hendrix gonna always try to, with his picking and his chords, like with the thumb. it's quite simple. If we're in C with the thumb, it's like double stub, and he likes to go there with an hammer there. And of course add the pinky. But the way he does it, he gets always creative with it, so that's a mystery. Us, we get lucky, we have the same sound, but you see how many cool sounds he did with, like, fire. Simple thing like this, or in the Stone Free. It's a little interesting touch. But of course there's a lot of this. Pretty much that I said. Just looking if I had something or not. Sorry, my style is like improvised. So yeah, try as an advice, which I try to do it myself, and I know it's difficult, but try to learn the song, to know it, like to play with a band or in a show, and you're okay. You know there's the solo part there. The solo is easier because you just solo, but you know it's on what chord behind you. You know what I mean? Just stick to the chord progression. Alright guys, I was short of inspiration, but let me know if you like it. Try to give little tips without having to okay, I'm gonna prepare a class or practice a hard song and try it to do it in the most perfectly possible, which is cool. I'm probably gonna do it again, but just, you know what I mean, it's a lot of work and a lot of things going on, working and job and other stuff. I play classical guitar too, do sports. It's hard to keep balance and keep progressing in your projects. So anyway, thanks guys for being my psychological help. Also, by doing this, I'm explaining my path. So yeah, that's it for today, and see you next time. Bye bye.